like one I've never conducted before. I'm doing this before prize giving in the gym hall when you are all not here. This year was an incomplete year, and as such our achievements were not so plentiful. As you know, I'm not competitive in the slightest. A wonderful achievement this year was the National Mod. Many of our children went to the Mod and they received accolades both representing the school and the island. We won a first and second in the choir and it was such a wonderful time. We were so proud. Our pipers continue to go from strength to strength and the music festival saw a healthy contingency from Skolnovoch. But not only in music, in sport too. Two of our P7s were selected to represent the island in the Lewis Select. We had regular runners in the cross country. We came first and second in the Unihoc Festival. We took part and achieved well in the Rugby Festival. Latterly, we held a football festival with Bach and Point schools where Skolnovoch came out trumps. I believe I would be standing here listing many more achievements should this year have been finished. However, this was not to be. Coronavirus has stripped the children this year of their education and their achievement, and no class has lost out more than P7. This prize giving, therefore, is not for the whole school. It is special in that it is just for P7. It is a celebration especially for them. They, unlike any P7 before them, did not get the send-off they deserved. They did not get their trip, their leavers assembly, their end-of-term parties, their special social. They did not lead on gala day. They did not get their house trophy. They did not get to sit on the stage at prize giving. This P7 did not get to display the P7-itis, which all P7s enjoy displaying in term 4. By P7-itis, I mean they are displaying signs that they need to go to the Nicholson. They roll their eyes when their teachers talk. They look at their head teacher in disgust when she tells a joke. They did not get the chance to develop P7-itis. They were still nice when they left. We decided to match the prizes to the children as best we could. As you can imagine, with such a diverse and able P7, that it was very difficult, and many children could have won many prizes. So some of the prizes were a real deliberation. Some shields that are traditionally shared, and this has helped our difficult decision making. I hope now that you enjoy our prize giving in all its virtual glamour.
The way we do it, the way we do it in the Western Isles.
An effective contributor will demonstrate an enterprising attitude, show resilience and self-reliance, be able to communicate in different ways in different settings, work collaboratively and take the initiative, apply critical thinking in new contexts and solve problems. Joel Fearon contributes well to class lessons and will speak with confidence and willingness in front of his class and to visitors. He is inquisitive and asks really interesting questions. He is reliable in class presentations and debating, which are important skills in the modern world. Well done, Joel Fearon. An effective contributor will demonstrate an enterprising attitude, show resilience and self-reliance, be able to communicate in different ways in different settings, working collaboratively and taking the initiative, applying critical thinking in new contexts to solve problems. Emily McLeod has matured well and has become a role model for younger pupils. She is kind and willing to help at any time and represent the school in many events, including the MOD and sporting events. She has helped with her library, she is reliable and has displayed a growing up attitude. It has been a pleasure to watch you develop, Emily, and we wish you all the best. A responsible citizen will demonstrate a respect for others and a commitment to act responsibly in and around the school and community. Show an understanding for environmental issues and other cultures and beliefs. Malachy Fearon is a polite and conscientious boy. He is a great tough buddy, promoting inclusion and looking out for his fellow peers. follows the rules and looks after his immediate and wider environment. So well done, Malchi Fieran. Responsible citizen will demonstrate a respect for others and a commitment to act responsibly in and around the school community. Show an understanding for environmental issues and other cultures and beliefs. Rhys Crossley is a caring and generous boy who always responds well to requests and is very helpful. He always looks out for younger children and takes his responsibility seriously. Well done, Rhys. Confident individual. A confident individual will demonstrate self-respect and a sense of physical and emotional well-being. They have secure values and beliefs and ambitions. They are able to relate to others and hold themselves appropriately. Communicate their own beliefs and view of the world. PJ, you have developed so well in that area. We are really proud of your achievements in Scornoval. You have pushed yourself and out of your comfort zone, and especially when you launched your competition. That was really brave. You've really proved great strength, and we believe you'll do well in the school for Nicholson. Okay, confident individual. A confident individual will just demonstrate self-respect and a sense of physical and emotional well-being. They will have secure values, which you do, and beliefs and ambition, which you do. They are able to relate to others and hold themselves appropriately, which you do. Communicate their own beliefs and view of the world. Rhiannon Fowler has displayed maturity and confidence and has contributed well to the life and work of the school. So representing the school at the MOD, but also on the Pupil Council and the Rights Respecting Schools Award. You'll be sorely missed, Rhiannon. Well done. Successful learner. A successful learner is a prize given to he or she who shows enthusiasm for learning, open to new ideas and thinking. They will have capabilities in communication, literacy and numeracy. They can think independently and creatively and apply their learning to different situations. The winners of this prize are Jaden Jacks. Jaden Jacks is new to the school and has already shown determination in her learning and proven that hard work pays off. Mrs. McLennan has reported that her effort in online learning has been very commendable. Well done, what an impression. Kayla has been truly successful this year and has developed so well over the years. It has been our pleasure to teach Kayla, and we are so proud of how she has adapted to every situation and how she has persevered through this lockdown. Well done, Kayla. Music tutor prizes. These prizes are chosen by the instructors for effort and improvement in their instrument. But also these children have contributed to the ethos of the school through their devotion to music. The prizes are going to Amy McLeod and Kuba Sukta. Amy is a wonderful singer and a real understanding for Gaelic music. Kuba Sukta is an amazing piper who has developed so well. He continues to go from strength to strength. Sports excellence. We would usually have sports medals at this point, but we have not had a sports day, so we have purchased special trophies to keep. They are to mark sporting excellence for the school. Both these boys have excelled as they got into the Island Select football team, but also in many other sporting achievements across the years, representing the school in chukball, rugby, unihawk, and many more. The Sporting Excellence prizes go to Kuba Sufta and Logan McLaren. This is a new prize this year, which we felt was very apt. It is an award for diligence. Logan McLaren has been a model pupil during lockdown, striving to finish all his work provided to the best of his ability. He's showing a real work ethic. Your teachers are very proud of you. So well done, Logan. Lucas McLeod has worked so hard over the course of his primary school life and has achieved so well. He has a real work ethic, and this will serve him well as he heads to the Nicholson. Next prize is for the North Loughs Historical Society Award for Culture and Heritage. Amy McLeod has represented the school so successfully in Gaelic singing, demonstrating a maturity and respect for Gaelic culture. She's also been hugely successful in Highland dancing, and she's ready to step up for the school at any time. We wish you all the best, Amy. Well done, you. Perseverance is another trophy which is not given out every year, but to a child who has thrived and has shown real determination. Calvin Matheson has pushed himself and challenged himself this year, and as a result been successful. He has shown through grit and perseverance throughout. He has shown he is ready to move on to secondary school. So our next prize is for citizenship, now the Andrew Murray Memorial Award. This is awarded to a particular individual who has shown kindness towards others and has put others before themselves. It is about friendship and inclusion. Andrew Murray was a school pupil who passed away 3 years ago. This is why we have found it apt to rename the trophy the Andrew Murray Memorial Award. Samuel McLeod has shown he is a wonderful role model when working with younger children and those with additional support needs. He is supportive and caring and gets the ethos of inclusion. Well done, Samuel. The Lyrbos Cup. The Lyrbos Cup is awarded to he or she who has demonstrated leadership throughout the school and has been an example of academic leadership. Cormac Sanderson will be awarded this prize. He only joined Scornoloch last year, but he has focused well on his studies and his academic achievement. He has demonstrated great leadership in the Pupil Council, Rights Respecting Schools Committee this year. Well done, Cormac. This cup is not a trophy we would expect to give out every year, but when there is someone who stands out and has demonstrated exceptional good writing, it is time to award this prize. This year we are giving this prize to a child who has continually demonstrated consistently good extended pieces of writing throughout the year, Kate McLeod. Kate has developed her written skills throughout her time in Scornoloch and is now writing wonderful extended pieces in both English and Gaelic. Her natural Gaelic language is a pleasure to read. Agus ar y side gyda sio, yn ba, fi yn moron o sio ar yn heli. The Fidigeri Cup. This is a cup for a child who has shown a great example throughout the year. He or she has represented the school at various events and is a credit to the school. Kerry McKinnon is a cracking example to all younger children. She is so proud of her language and will strive to speak it. Her behaviour and attitude is impeccable, and she will be sorely missed in Scornoloch. We should get the young drink of more, Kerry. The Quake is awarded to a group or an individual who has been a credit to our school. This boy has represented the school at the Mod, the cross country, and football. He is kind and caring to younger pupils and friendly to all his peers. Indeed, a credit to our school. It is our pleasure to award the Quake this year to Cameron McLeod. Our next prize is for academic excellence across the board. In the traditional sense, it is the ducks. This is the second year the ducks has been given out. This year, we would like to present the second ducks to Tharamath MacLeod. Tharamath has shown throughout the years a passion for challenge and new learning. He is enthusiastic and keen. He gets it from his mother. Well, that is it. A virtual lockdown prize giving for all P7. With John Sweeney's news on Tuesday, we hope that the virus will be kept at bay and that all the children can return to school in August. This bunch did not get their transition like they should have, but I have no doubt that they will succeed and will be a credit to our school. Please remember to come back and visit us at Scorn na Bóg, and good luck with everything you do. Marcin Live.
These you learn to love again.